Brian, ultimately, it's a ship with two missions, one during times of war, the other humanitarian. Today, San Diego said goodbye to the hospital ship Mercy with a message that help is on the
Brian,
way.
The only way to describe this sinkhole is unbelievably massive. Take a look, 10 feet wide, at least 25 feet deep, and growing larger by the hour.
Tonight, the focus is on safety, making sure that this property owner and her family are out of the house and stay out of the house until the cause can be found and repairs can be made.
Word from stadium officials tonight is if you're planning on being at the game tomorrow, keep it dry. Wear your rain poncho, bring waterproof shoes if you have them, but as far as umbrellas are concerned, they are a no-no. They'll be confiscated.
Sustained at about 40 to 50 miles per hour. They're gusting to 70 miles per hour.
Callisto is about the size of the planet Mercury. NASA compares this flyby to zipping by a basketball at the distance of an inch and a half.
The link between air pollution and heart disease might be somewhat cloudy. The effect of heart disease on our society is crystal clear. But what is even more shocking is this area is only producing one-third of its total capacity. When we tested the waters there, we found more than good old H2O. Our tests show there's feces in the water. There's at least 40 toxic air contaminants in diesel exhaust. Why shouldn't we pass new laws creating stricter regulations?
It's been 83 degrees inside my vehicle just about 15 minutes ago. Let's get an update. We have placed the thermometer directly on the CPR dummy, and as you can see, a whopping 20-degree rise in temperatures. Highway 58 eastbound will be reopened, which is certainly good news for the scores of motorists you can see lined up here trying to head eastbound on Highway 58 who've spent a good part of the day sitting, going nowhere fast.
Well, keep in mind, California is only deregulating the power generating industry, not the transmission and distribution industry, which remain under regulatory control. Many will be turning to wood-burning stoves and fireplaces to keep warm this winter. But burning wood does more than create heat. It contributes to an already significant air pollution problem. Then and only when the county health department is absolutely convinced the public is safe will the swim area be reopened. Well, if all goes well, Galileo's own fate will be a suicide plunge into Jupiter's crushing atmosphere in the year 2003. It's a state-of-the-art facility, one of the most sophisticated water treatment plants in the nation, and it's right here in our own backyard. Known as the Northeast Project, its mission is to feed the water demands of a growing population.